Good morning, church, or good afternoon. You know, when Pastor asked me the last Sunday I was here if I'm ready, I said no, but I'm ready for the next Sunday. But I continue to be tarrying and to say what my topic should be. And one night I went to my bed and I dreamt seeing these doors. And I said, you know what? I am going to tarry with the topic. But this morning, more than all, I am so happy. I have my grandson in the house with me and two of my daughters. And I am sure I did not plan it, but God has planned it. If you would just turn your Bibles with me to Revelation chapter 3, verse 20. Let us read together. Behold, I stand at the door. You found it?
Yes.
Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come in to him and will sup with him and he with me. Thank you. This is the most outstanding text of the scripture. There is something about it that each time when I read it, it just thrills my heart. It is a picture of the Lord knocking at the door. This is an illustration. This artist painted a picture of Jesus knocking at the door. When it went through the critics, one rose and said, "Sir, there's just one thing I can find wrong with the picture. That is, you do not have any lock on the door." And the artist said, "Oh no, I painted it that way," he said. "That door is a door to the heart. And the lock is on the inside. You have to open it." And so, I chose the topic, the door to the heart. In the Bible, both Old Testament and New Testament, the word door is mentioned in the Bible 46 times. Between the Old Testament and the New Testament, the word heart is mentioned 100 times. So it's to say how important these two words are. As we would wonder, as we hear knocking at the door, what does a person knock on the door for? The person is trying to gain entrance. He or she wants to come in. That's the reason for knocking. If President Obama knocked at any one of us door, we would feel honored. Because he is not just anyone. He is the President of the United States of America. We would welcome him so much and try to offer him the best in our house. But he is no more important than our Lord Jesus. Who is more turned away in our lives than Jesus? Who is greater than he is? And yet he stands and knocks daily, and we turn him away. He wants to gain entrance to our heart so that he can bless us and do for us what no president or no other person could do. And yet we turn him away. Daily, 1,000 times, thousands turn him away from their heart's door. One might say, "Jesus knocked at my heart, I let him in." But when he comes in into our heart, did you welcome him to your entire being? There are little doors. One of them is a little door of self. And there's another little door, it's called the door to selfishness. And another door of pride and others. Those doors need to open and let Jesus in. Jesus do not want us to be like the Joneses or act like your neighbors, but he wants us to act and behave like his child and get away from anything that is not of him. Let me put in this little door, and it is faith. We are to open it wide and let the King of Glory come into it. Then we'll be able to see the great things and believe with all our heart that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. As I conclude, brothers and sisters, young men, young women, boys and girls, a door is very essential to anywhere because that is the only way to gain entrance. For example, when it is hot or cold, we need to feel cool or warm, and the way to be comfortable is to be inside. And that is what the Lord wants from us, to open the door of our hearts and let him in. So today and right now, no peephole, no chain, no lock on the art door. Let Jesus in. God bless. Merry Christmas.